Today I'm going to talk to you about how to prevent developing a diabetic ulcer or wound in your foot. The first and most important thing to do is on a daily basis, you must look at the foot, and this means the bottom of your foot, the hardest place to see, particularly if it's hard to bend down, which means either you use a mirror or you use a loved one who can look at the bottom of that foot on a daily basis. So what are you looking for? It's pretty simple. You're looking for areas of cracked skin and certainly any areas of redness. And maybe even more easily, if you take the sock off or you take yesterday's sock and you see that there is any blood in it, it's an immediate sign of danger. Cracked skin. What do you do when you have cracked skin? Maybe you use a moisturizing cream. But these cracks can develop into deeper fissures. And if you're diabetic, you may not feel it. So if you see that you're looking at your skin and now dry skin is becoming a deeper cracked skin, this is a signal to act. Redness. Redness is not normal. And it can be very small, but localized around a wound is a definite sign of impending infection and a need to act. Finally, if you either have an open wound or an area that's become soft and is discolored, there's a wound under the skin about to open, and it's a sign to act. After you've inspected the foot, you need to write it down, share it with someone, and finally act on it. If you call our office with any of these worrisome signs, you won't be waiting long to get in. Often that day, we want you in the office to prevent an emergency. And an emergency means that you have an infection that requires hospitalization. So, if you're diabetic and you have signs of redness, dry cracked skin, an open wound, or an area that's changed in color from the way it's been looking, look at your feet daily, contact us immediately, and let's help you keep these feet attached.